Hi, this is Lata from AstroLata.com with your October 2019 videos, and I have great news for you. The astrological cosmic weather will be sunny. It will be like a breath of fresh air. All the planets are moving forward, which means that we can move ahead with our lives and goals and plans. We'll be very productive as well. We'll be very initiative because the Libra season is season of action. And because there are no retrograde planets this month, it means that things go according to our expectations. We don't get frustrated because of delays, because of obstacles. We don't have to think of plan B and C. So move ahead with confidence and positivity. The star will support you. And even some of you might have difficult personal transits because everyone has a horoscope that no one else in the world has, you know. And you can check what your personal transits will be like from my birth chart, from my birth transit calendar, basically, which is for free. And here you can see how it looks from astrolada.com, and you can see all those transits specifically for me. No one else in the world has them at the same time with me. And if you happen to see a difficult transit here, they have explanations, for example, like this one, you know, and it's more complex, it's more difficult. Still don't worry, because overall, the astrological weather that I'm talking about in those videos will be so positive that it will basically, the outer circumstances will support you, will help you overcome whatever difficulty it is in your personal horoscope. And this is a season of love and relationships as well in October. It will be very much focused on relationships, on others, on bonding with others, because this is Libra season after all. And because of that, me and Natalia are making a webinar, two-part webinar in 2 days on love and sex. Natalia will focus on the practical side, on how to bond sexually with the different signs. I will focus on the love aspect of it. It's for beginners or advanced people. I'll give you my deep insights. What does each sign want? What does each sign love? How to be loved? The love languages of the different signs and the positions that show those love languages. So do join us towards the end of October sometime. And also, there's still open places for Bali with me and Natalia. Very, very boutique retreat. Now it's open also for men. It's webinar to focus on giving birth to your goddess, inner goddess, and god or inner god. And I'll work specifically with each person on their personal horoscope. And Natalia will work individually with each person and each woman or man on their issues. So that's very tailor-made. All right, so let's dig into the October horoscopes. Aries, sun, moon, or ascendant. This is what October holds for you. So you see, this is Aries here. Just a second. Whoop. Where are you? Here we go. This is Aries, and you see that most of the important planets, these are the seven traditional planets that are visible for you, will be above the horizon. You're starting a period of a few months now, Aries, basically almost till the spring, but especially now in October, where you will become especially busy. When most of the planets are above the horizon, and for you, all the planets are going to be above the horizon, we're talking the traditional planets, from October onwards, then the upper part of the horizon you see above, the sign Aries, basically, this is the horizon. It indicates more visibility, more public activity. It indicates more being in the public eye and being more productive, getting things done. So when planets are above the horizon transiting, we're more introspective. We work more within on ourselves. But when they go above, we can reach out more people. We can do bigger things, more visible things that we're recognized for as well. We can be generally more productive, you know, generally more and recognized because of that. And let's see where the biggest focus is. Well, a big part of the month is focus on Libra, your seventh house, you know, the seventh from Aries, the two action planets, the Sun and Mars. They're the initiative masculine planets. And oops, sorry, the green keeps disappearing. but I'm just going to show you quickly. The two masculine planets are in your seventh house. So it seems that your actions are getting triggered because of other people. You're receiving feedback from someone, or someone, you know, you're communicating with someone or collaborating with someone, or someone writes to you or speaks to you, and they trigger into action because of that. And they might not be the gentlest and the smoothest. They might tell you things through the martial or sun way with authority. They can be a bit angry and tell you this is not working or this is not the best way. And they can trigger you to evaluate the situation and get moving and get change something, because the Libra is the sign of change. So it's the seventh house, the cardinal house. And especially to make changes in your relationships with others, with clients, with partners, with business partners, with personal business relationships as well. But there'll be a lot of initiative people around you. These two masculine planets, Sun and Mars, are very initiative. So you others might be pushing and saying, let's do this, let's do that. And you'll do well if you take those initiatives, if you take those offers from others. Because now your power, because the Sun and Mars are the two planets of power, they're our fuel. Being in the seventh house means that your fuel comes by collaborating with others, that your big initiatives and drives and ambitions are some kind of somehow entwined with the interests of others. They're entwined to serve the interests of others or to do something together with another person. But again, they can be people that are more martial around you, and solar, which means like more confident or stronger or pushier or bossy in some way. And to be honest, because this is your seventh house after all, it shows your attitude towards other people. That's why you attract such people, because your attitude is becoming more proactive towards others. So when the action planets are in your seventh house, it means that you will also become proactive in approaching others. How I see this happen usually is that you might, for example, approach new clients. You try to actively pursue new contracts or agreements with others, or actively pursue collaborations with others. You can actively pursue partners in the personal life. For example, you can be the one that you're motivating, that you're putting your energy into doing something with a partner to motivate them, but they also can be the one motivating, but you're not doing things alone. Also, it's a bit harder to collaborate with people when the Sun and Mars are in the seventh house, because they're very strongly opinionated people. Either you're the one that wants to be, yes, let's do this together, but I'm going to be the leader, or the other person. So you have to know that there will be some kind of imbalance in power a little bit, that one will be the leader, depending who is the stronger personality, while the other has to follow. But knowing this, you would be able to avoid confrontations, because Mars in the seventh house can often create people that are pressing our buttons. It might be clients that say something to you that pisses you off, but it triggers you into action to change something, you know, to improve the relationship, because Mars is a planet of improving things. It wants to improve. It's ultimate to fix something, you know. Also, there might be some arguments with people, some conflicts that happen, some confrontation, clashes of opinions, because as I said, around you, there are people with very strong opinions this month, and so are you like that. And it's important to use this, not to this energy that you get triggered, not to get angry and fight with others and to be reactive. Instead, when you feel reactive and triggered by others, wait a couple of days, then respond. Wait a few minutes or an hour, then respond, with more consideration for their side as well, their side of the story. And use that fire that they create in you, this anger or trigger, to basically do something useful, to do something that triggers you into improving those relationships in some way rather than destroying them. On another level, you know, this, you can be very proactive as well in business, because the seventh house is very business oriented. So if you're into sales, into being with clients on one-to-one basis, this can trigger you into proactively basically looking for the rights that make the relationships more, or the contract or the agreement. And even you might be willing yourself to confront others so things are more fair, because Mars in Libra wants to fight for fairness, for what is fair in this contract, in these relationships. But again, you proactively are very busy with other people. You're very busy with business as well, the seventh house. It's exchanging ideas with others and making them happen. And you're very busy as well with reaching the public, reaching wider audiences, and forging contracts or agreements that you almost like might push people by the wall and say, okay, these are my rules, you know. Towards the end of October, Mars will make square with Saturn in the 10th house. So you might have to overcome some difficulty the last week of October. And this difficulty will come through a clash with some authority figure, for example, or if you're the authority figure, some other person will clash with your authority and challenge you in some way. But because the neutral reception, Mars is in the exaltation sign of Saturn, Saturn is in the exaltation sign of Mars. So they are looking to work together despite of the difficult aspect to push you to do something very creative, to do something very constructive. So the final result of this challenge, there might be, for example, a lot more work because of clients, you know, Saturn, the 10th house is work or extra duties and responsibilities that come to you to fix something at work because of a confrontation with a client, or maybe there might be confrontation with a personal partner because of a work situation in you, because of you're trying to use your authority in some way, some clash, you know, basically towards the end of the week or of the month. And to overcome that, as I said, these two planets want to work together because of the signs they're in. So you just have to buckle up a bit the last week and be more patient in your actions. Don't fire immediately and get aggressive. And you'll get a lot of things done, and you can really contribute a lot to business, to career, to reputation. You can get, or if you have some clash with a boss figure, for example, again, try to be, they're trying to do it for your best. Or if you're the boss figure, you might be clashing with others, with clients, you know, with partners. But the ultimate purpose of that is to make this area, the seventh and the 10th house, better. To make the field of relationships and agreements and contracts and the field of career to overcome some difficulty, not only, but to work hard on it, and you can have a very productive final result. Also, your partners, marriage partner, can be, for example, very busy and become very initiative now. They can take on some physical activity. This fantastic month to take up some physical activity together with a partner, so it does not flare up into fighting, for example, some more challenging project together, and to move ahead with it. All right. Then we have Venus and Mercury, most of October, in the sign of Scorpio. Venus and Mercury are both so-called benefic planets, which means that this eighth house, Scorpio for you Aries, will be area of very positive and easy developments. You know, while with relationships and contracts, there is a bit like effort has to be exerted, physical efforts, because that's Mars and the Sun. You have to mobilize your willpower in order to fulfill those relationships. You have to go after them. So there might be some hiccups, but you know, the ultimate result again is for good. But when it comes to eighth house matters, which is intimacy, much deeper relationships. These are not relationships with clients. These are relationships that you have intimacy, bond with someone, trust, very deep trust. Well, there is where you receive the healing and the beautiful balancing influences of both Venus and Mercury. So that can be, for example, improvement of your love life, especially the deeper intimacy in a relationship. It can be deepening of some existing relationship already. This can be pleasant experiences through secret or personal, very personal, private relationships. But the eighth house is also resources that comes to us from others. So Mercury and Venus will bring, for example, if you depend on money from clients, if you depend on some payment from government, if you depend on alimony from a ex-partner, if you depend on some stipend, if you depend, or if you're want to find resources, so for example, some kind of supplies for your business that come from another place, you can be granted with positive results. It will happen smoothly, easily, harmoniously. You can receive money from another. You can receive moral, emotional, psychological support from another. If you're trying to they can be very smooth developments in matters regarding inheritances, insurances, or taxes. If you're trying to do your taxes, that can be a good month to get cracking or ask for support, because you'll find the right partner, the right people as well. And the eighth house is the house of ask and you shall receive. You can receive something from the universe that you have not put efforts from, that is given to you as a gift from another person or another source. So if you need support or help from someone, this is the month to ask from. You see, most of the most important planets here in the 7th and 8th, these are houses of other people. So now your strength and your power comes from collaborating with others. Try not to dominate them too much or get into power struggles with them, because you can receive a lot from them. Or if you have a business that depends on clients or working with others, partners and things, or investments from others, this can give good results, good yields. The finances can increase, and Venus is already visible. So now resources coming to you from others and support from others will definitely be way more visible than in other parts of the year. And as you can see, Jupiter continues to be in your ninth house moving forward. That can be amazing for a lot of areas that will feel more optimistic, positive, more faith, more belief in a higher power, more luck being at the right place at the right time as well. Very supportive, especially people that are from around 15 degrees Aries, Sun Moon or Ascendant to around 24 degrees Aries, Sun Moon or Ascendant. So that's about 10 degrees. You can check what your degrees are basically. I would say from around the 5th of April to around the 14th of April, they'll feel the very positive influences of Jupiter. It can bring some opportunities for career, for abundance, for more blessings, opportunities to travel, opportunities to study, to be in foreign countries, because Jupiter is from the ninth house, to discover belief system, or to discover worldviews that are more aligned with the divine truth as well, and to become more moral in a sense as well. And Saturn continues to be in your 10th house, asking you to work hard, to continue to follow the rules when it comes to responsibilities and duties, and to follow the traditional, you know, not to skip a few steps. But that Saturn has been there for a long time, but it's moving direct already in October. So complications and difficulties with your career are getting resolved. They're moving forward. And you can be productive in regards to their, yes, they can be still a lot of responsibilities, but they're giving good results and they're happening according to your expectations. So thank you so much, Aries. Hope you join me and Natalia on the webinar, today webinar on love and sex in October, or in Bali for that, you know, if you want a more personal experience. Thank you.